what to expect after retinal detachment surgery. This is Dr. Anina Abraham from Advanced Retina Care. We are doing a patient education series on retinal detachment to help you understand what this is all about. You don't have to worry about retinal detachment surgery. This is definitely one of the most complicated surgeries in the eye. However, technology has advanced so much that we can do away with sutures. You don't need stitches inside the eye. Very fine instruments are passed into the eye and the treatment is done. Your retina is settled and the next day, your eye can appear as if it is untouched. That is the beauty of advanced retinal detachment surgery. So what can you expect? First of all, you will need to undergo local anesthesia. Very, very rarely, general anesthesia is given for these cases. Local anesthesia meaning an injection is given in the lower lid, in the peribulbar space, which is the area around the eye. We do not poke the eye. And this anesthesia helps to stop all eye movement and completely eliminates your pain for the next 2 hours. Once your eye is anesthetized, you're completely draped and the surgery begins. In this procedure, first, the vitreous gel is completely removed in a process called vitrectomy. All the fluid is completely drained from under the retina and the retina is settled with air. Once air is injected to completely flatten the retina, this is replaced with oil or gas. Laser treatment or cryotherapy is done to that particular break which is responsible for this, and then the instruments are removed from the eye. This is how the procedure is done. But what is important is to settle the retina completely on the operation table. Sometimes the retina does not settle. If it is not settling, it's possibly because the break has not been treated properly, or the vitreous has not been removed completely, or the retina is extremely stiff and there are membranes all over the retina, or some intraoperative complication has happened. Your doctor will know what that problem is. Once the surgery is done, a patch will be applied on the eye, and you will be given a particular position to sleep in, depending upon the position of the break on your retina. So what you need to expect from this is you need to give yourselves 2 weeks of time on the bed. Complete bed rest, which is going to help your retina heal and even push that oil into that position and flatten out your retina. This is extremely important. Post-operative positioning is what will finally determine the success of your surgery. Inferior retinal detachments are much harder to treat because the position of the break is down. But we normally recommend a one-sided position instead of a completely prone position. Well, that's what I recommend. And I found excellent success if your position is to one side instead of completely prone. Now, if oil is injected inside the eye, we cannot leave that oil inside the eye. We have to remove the oil after the retina is fully settled. Now, some patients, after the oil is removed, they come back again with a retinal detachment. The reason is because you have not checked for retinal detachment under the oil. There are times where the retina has not settled and you still go in and remove the oil, and that's when your retina redetaches. It's very rare to have a redetachment after oil removal if you have settled the retina absolutely 100% well.